quarterfinal day in the Nations Cup last weekend. Let's go around the world and see who made the last four.
Starting in Vienna, where the hosts held Dublin for 25 minutes before Kate Good sent the Irish on their way to the semi-finals. The Wilston sweeper is now aiming to be the first player to complete a personal treble of Championship, Cup and Nations Cup in the same season.
Nicole Lesch bagged a hat-trick in the game of the day in Munich, where the unified German team came from an early setback to hold a narrow advantage over the Belgians at the break before the teenage Potsdam shooter put the tie beyond doubt in the third quarter.
However, it's the Welsh the rest have to stop. They're the favorites and they showed it in an impressive 7-goal victory in Athens, where Cardiff's Elizabeth Courtney Stringer had a hat-trick. Like her Wilson teammates Reese and Anstis, Licky Davis also has personal treble ambitions, with the trio due to meet on opposite sides in the Open Cup quarterfinals in a couple of weeks. The Americans complete the semi-final quartet after they put paid to the Dutch in Houston, with Loretta Rachopi scoring in front of her home crowd before the visitor set up a nervy ending.
In the Nations Cup, only the final is staged at a neutral venue, which this year will be in Paris after the defending champions lost to Ireland in the last 16, so the Irish must travel across the Atlantic to face the States next month, while Germany have a tough assignment in Cardiff. On to this evening's final games in round 2, and the WGF have granted postponements for the games in Plymouth and Munich to save Dublin and Croydon the expense of having to travel for what were two games with nothing to play for, as all four teams lost their remaining qualifying hopes a fortnight ago. That leaves 6 games instead of 8.
West Ham face Lanarkshire to decide who wins Group A, though it's hard to see what, if any, advantage winning the group will have, as both quarterfinal groups are going to be equally tough. Hammers coach Ann Gardner's press rating has gone up to 5, excellent. Magda Miller scored the only goal when these two met in Scotland a few weeks ago. A tie might be enough to see Monmouthshire into the quarterfinals, as long as Cork don't get an unlikely bonus point in Liverpool in the other game in this group. For Brooklyn, it's a must-win, and while they're the underdogs, they can take heart from their surprise 2-0 win in Wales a few weeks ago, when Alice Afrunski and Jessica Asp were both on target.
Only a very unlikely heavy defeat would endanger Liverpool's quarterfinal ambitions, and even then it would also need Monmouthshire to win, scoring at least 3 goals more than Liverpool do. The team remains unsettled, with Audrey O'Neill sitting this one out after being sin-binned in Brooklyn, while Diana Arnold returns from a jarred knee. All Cork can do is win here, and hope the other game goes their way, with a 0-0 being the best result they could hope for in New York.
Munich vs Croydon is a postponed dead rubber, which leaves St. Louis and Glasgow to fight it out for the honor of going into the quarterfinals as group winners. The advantage is Glasgow's, who need only to avoid defeat, while St. Louis continue to build for next year as they welcome back the teenager who got away 4 years ago. Attacker Fontella Fraser has spent the last 4 years in England and returns from Sheffield and is viewed as a star of the future.
A late equaliser in Cheshire last time out gave Belfast the tiniest glimmer of hope of progressing out of this group, but they need a bonus point. Most of their flu victims have returned, but they still play third-choice goalie Nimmons. Wilsdon qualified despite their shock defeat in Manhattan a fortnight ago and will cement their place as group winners with a tie. But they'll be without Kate Good, who picked up a dead leg on international duty with Ireland last weekend.
That shock win over Wilsdon last time out was brilliant for Manhattan, but they didn't pick up the bonus point they desperately needed and now have to try and do it to the champions. Cheshire welcomed back Jenny Tresillian in goal as the only change from the side held by Belfast, and a tie here would be enough to make certain their defense of the title continues.
So Tallahassee Lassie from Tommy Steele at number 18 in this week's UK chart took us through the team news. And to get the games underway, this is Mona Lisa by Conway Twitty at 22.
Well, in a villa in a little old house. What does she want? I guess nobody knows. Ooh, is your smile to tempt a lover, Mona Lisa? Or is this your way to hide a broken heart? Are you wrong? Are you real, Mona Lisa? The cold and lonely of your world of art. The cold and lonely.
The end of the second round, and it's joy for Liverpool, Monmouthshire and Cheshire. Disappointment for Brooklyn, Cork, Belfast and Manhattan. The Liverbirds were happy to keep Cork at arm's length, with the Irish unable to get the goal that would have taken them through instead of Monmouthshire. Their tie kept out Brooklyn, who will also reflect on falling one goal short of the last eight. Cheshire were never in any real danger of suffering the heavy defeat that would have seen them lose their place to Manhattan, while Belfast's remote hopes were crushed by Wolseley in what was the only decisive result in a day of close games.
And this is how the final tables look. Games on the final day that had no impact on the groups were postponed and won't be played, so that means we have four former champs winning the groups while the current champs are joined by three teams bidding to lift the title for the first time. Half of the last eight hail from England, two are from Scotland and one each from the USA and Wales.
Rosalie Williams and Jean Anstis have formed a partnership that's smashing their opponents this season. Hat-tricks for both again today in Belfast, and the 40-year-old Williams is looking good to retain her golden bat. Betty Chalmers keeps the pressure up with a goal against Lanarkshire. Lynn Cox is still banging in goals in the repêchage for Manchester and the Nations Cup for Ireland. And although she didn't score today, it should be remembered that Catherine Malloy is primarily a defender.
Wilson and Cork dominate the team of the week this weekend, the former for being the only team to actually win, and the latter for stifling Liverpool.
There's no such thing as an easy quarterfinal, so for these eight it will be a cutthroat few weeks as they try to win their group. The winners of each will meet in the final with the runners-up playing for the bronze medal.
No rest for the big guns, at least not next week, as Wilson, West Ham, Lanarkshire and Liverpool have been kept apart as fate would have it in the Open Cup quarterfinals. The quartet will be taking their next step in their bid to win the championship and cup double, while for Cork, who exited the championship today, this is their last competitive gridball for the season. Norfolk will welcome a break from their demotion battle, while for Nottingham it might be a distraction from their bid to join the elite next term. The rank outsiders are Helsinki, the second division side who failed to make the playoffs this year.
Gridball is a fictional women's team sport set in 1959. And you can find out more about it at gridball.org. You can also like and subscribe, as well as hitting that bell to be informed of the next game. No Gridball broadcast next weekend as the elite teams prepare for the quarterfinals.
Our background music today came from the UK pop chart of August 1959 with Tommy Steele singing Tallahassee Lassie at number 18, Conway Twitty's Mona Lisa at 22, Russ Conway at 23 with China Tea, Ronnie Hilton with The Wonder of You at 24, and the Impalas at 28 with Sorry.